Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To start today's video, there was a tweet posted saying, received the second shipment of Starlink stations. Elon Musk keeps his word. Thank you for supporting Ukraine and peace in the entire world. Musk responded with, you're welcome. We have also sent power adapters for car cigarette lighters, solar battery packs and generators for places where electricity is not available. There is an interesting article that I want to share. It says, SpaceX is partnering with the University of Arizona College of Medicine, Phoenix, to offer a one-year fellowship to study space surgery. The fellowship offers training on austere surgical care which involves surgery in extreme and resource-restrained environments like space. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. There's a new structure being put together just behind the launch site wall. A claw of the Starship quick disconnect arm was removed from the tower. The work on the wide bay in the production yard is continuing. There was a picture posted on Twitter related to Roberts Road. It says the first segment of the SpaceX Starship launch tower at Cape Canaveral has started construction. Exciting times we live in. Somebody posted a picture on Twitter saying the capability of Starship is mind-blowing. Musk responded and said, optimized fully reusable Starship is approximately 150 tons to same reference orbit as Saturn V. In expendable mode, Starship payload would be 250 tons to 300 tons. NASA has posted a new document with some new human landing system details, but this picture is what I wanted to share. Here's a cool view of how some of the components of a HLS Starship could look. This Ship 24 nose cone barrel section has been receiving some heat shield tile blankets. Here's a view of the Starship 25 aft ring stack which was flipped in the yard to be sleeved with a bulkhead. Here's the Ship 25 aft dome waiting to be sleeved. The two were then sleeved with one another to form Ship 25's aft section. There was not necessarily any testing, but Booster 4 was seen venting a bit recently. Nick Ansuini posted a picture on Twitter with SpaceX testing the Super Heavy Booster 4 grid fins. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, the dates for the end of last week were cancelled. However, we can hopefully expect some testing this coming week with closures from tomorrow Monday 14th up until Thursday 17th. Super Heavy Booster 7 is now fully stacked in the high bay. This upper stack for Booster 8 was moved into the high bay. On the left here you can see a barrel section moved outside which is the Super Heavy Booster 9. This common dome for Booster 9 was placed on the sleeving mount. Then these two pieces were sleeved to form the common dome section of Booster 9. As always I have to say thank you to both Mary, also known as Boca Chica Gal, and Nick Ansuini who are both out there all the time filming the Boca Chica content. Also thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.